Welcome back children. Till yesterday we have learned how to draw a perfect circle using a compass. Some other important points while using the compass also we have explained or we'll discussed. Now let's continue our lesson. Today we will start our next topic at the page number 90 is find the center. Sadiq and Samina want to make circles for themselves. I will make it with a compass. No, I will trace it with a bangle. So both the children decided to draw circles. Sadiq decided to draw a circle by using a compass, but Samina decided to draw a circle by using a bangle. Both of them drawn their own circles. See, both of them drew the circle and after that they cut out the circles. They taken the shape of the circle separately. Now Sadiq saying, see, my circle has a center, but where is the center of your circle? Sadiq asked to Samina, where is the center of your circle? Because Samina drew the circle, or she traced the circle. She has drawn the circle by using a bangle. So she was traced the circle. So she did not get a center for the circle. But Sadiq showed his circle which has a center point, because he drew the circle using the compass. When we drew a circle by using a compass, we will get the center of the circle where we kept the pointed arm of the circle, arm of the compass. But Samina did not get the center point of the circle. But she has one idea. What is the idea? Let's see. She folded her circle into two half. See how she folded her circle. And after that, then she folded it again. Again she folded that circle in again. See, she opened the folded circle. Now Samina asked to Sadiq, can you see the two creased lines crossing each other? After folding the circle, Samina opened the circle. Then we can see two creased lines crossing each other. See, that are the dotted lines, the creased lines. There is a center point. That means that two creased lines are crossing at a center point. Yes, Sadiq sir, yes, I can see. See, I put a point where these lines cross. This is the center of my circle. As she drew the circle by using or tracing a bangle, she find out the center of the circle by folding the circle into two halves by crossing two lines or creased lines. Where the creased line cross each other, that is the center of the circle Samina find out. Students, in this way we can find the center point of any circle or center of the any circle by folding the paper into two halves or creased lines. Where the creased lines cross, we can find out the center point of the circle. Now you trace a circle on a paper using a bangle, cut it, then find its center like Samina did. Students, you can also do this activity at home. Draw a circle using a bangle, fold the paper, fold that circle into two parts and open that circle, cut it, open that circle and find the center of the circle. Now the next topic is, this we have already done in the page 88, how we can draw this design in using a circle. We can also make the design on page number 88 like this. How did you do it? This topic I have explained in the previous video, so we don't want to discuss today. Now we'll move to the next page. The topic is balancing act. See, these are some pictures for balancing objects from its center. Student, these are some common balancing objects. The first one is, some people balance the football on their fingers or from their nose or by the head. Some acrobats are also balancing a plate on the stick. Children, mostly the children are playing with this top and they are spinning this top by balancing from its center, the pointed end of the top. So this is the balancing act. In our textbook, it is given that, can you balance a plate on your finger? I will balance it. Oops, I will try again. I think I have found the center of the plate. Here two monkeys are there. They are trying to balance a plate. The first one is trying to balance the plate from the side of the object. But the next one is balancing the plate from its center. So who can balance it properly, students? The second monkey can balance that plate properly because that monkey find out the center of the plate. That means, students, any object we can balance from the center of that object. That means we can balance on any object from the center of it because the distance from the center of the object and the side of the object will be always same. That's why we can balance any object from its center. So if you want to balance any object, find the center of the object and try to balance it. This is the topic about balancing act. Our next topic is spin the top. In this topic, Sakir, Appu, Naina and Guddu were getting bored. It was raining, so they could not go out to play. The four children were sitting in their room because they were raining outside. So they cannot go outside or they could not go out to play. Suddenly, Appu had an idea. What was the idea? Appu said, "Let's each make a top." So they decided to make a top. What they have done for that? They took a piece of cardboard, traced a circle on it. They took a cardboard and traced the circle. Then they made a hole and put a matchstick in it. All the four children made their own circles and put a hole in that circle and insert a matchstick on it. And now everybody was excited to spin their tops, which looked like this. Now the children were very happy to spin their tops or spin their circles, which looked like this. Here, the tops, the pictures of the tops which the four children had made given here. The first picture is Sakir's top or Sakir's circle. Second one is Appu's. Third one, Naina's circle. The last one is Guddu's circle. Students, observe all the circles. What difference can you see in these circles? In Sakir's circle, he had made the circle and put the hole in at the side of the circle and put the matchstick in that hole. But Appu had made a hole in the center of the circle. Naina made a hole at the side only and inserted the matchstick. And Guddu made a circle and inserted the matchstick near to the center of the circle. And we have asked four questions here. The first question is, whose top will not spin at all? Whose top will not spin at all? Students, we know that to balance or spin any circular object, we have to spin it from its center. Here, whose top will not spin at all? Here, Sakir and Naina had made the hole at the side of the circle. It is not at the center. So, these two children's circle will not spin at all. So, you write the answer. The circle of Sakir and Naina's top will not spin at all. Now the second question is, whose top will spin a little? Whose top will spin a little? If you want to spin a circle, we have to spin it from the center. So there is a chance of spinning a little is there, Guddu's circle, because he has made the hole from near to the center. So you have to write the answer there, Guddu's circle. Now, whose top will spin the best? Whose top will spin the best? From the picture, we understood that Appu's circle will spin the best because he has made the hole from the center and put the stick. So, his circle can spin the best, Appu's circle. Now, the last question is, in whose top is the stick nearest to the center? Whose top is or whose circle is the stick nearest to the center? Guddu's circle. Guddu's circle is the stick is nearest to the center. Now for all the four questions answers we have done here. So the reason for this top or the circle spinning by not at all or spin a little or spin the best, the reason is that if you want to spin a circle or a round object, we have to balance it from the center. Only from the center only the circles can spin properly. Now, make your own top. You also make your own top and play this game. To make a top, spin well. Where will you make the hole? To make a top and spin it well, where we have to make the hole? To spin it properly, we have to make the hole from the center or at the center. Students, now we have completed this lesson. Now we will continue our workbook from the next video.